إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليما كثيرا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله Indeed the most truthful of speech is the book of Allah وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم And the best guidance is the guidance of our beloved messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَشَرُّ الْأُمُورِ مُحْدَثَاتُهَا And the worst of affairs are those things we newly invent into this religion of ours. وَكُلَّ مُحْدَثَةٍ بِدْعَةٍ And everything we newly invent into this religion of ours is misguidance and it leads astray. وَكُلَّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَةٍ وَكُلَّ ضَلَالَةٍ فِي النَّارِ And every innovation in this deen of ours is misguidance and it leads astray, and every misguidance and going astray is in the hellfire. ثُمَّ أَمَّا بَعْدُ Today, a simple message. Falling back on the message from last week. When we see what Allah is sending to the earth in terms of hurricanes and earthquakes, flooding, and what we see as disasters, but they are nothing but signs for us to reflect upon. And there's a direct correlation with what we are doing as humans in this dunya, on this dunya, in this life. So today's message to back up on last week's is the statement of Allah. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ وَإِذَا أَرَادَ اللَّهُ بِقَوْمٍ سُوءًا فَلَا مَرَدَّ لَهُ وَمَا لَهُم مِّن دُونِهِ مِنْ وَالٍ To fall back on last week's discussion is the statement of Allah. Verily Allah will not change the good state or condition a people are in until they change what is in themselves. Ya'ni, if people are upon goodness, then Allah will always bless them with a good condition. And if people are upon evil, then nothing will get them away from their pitiful condition until they leave that evil. But when Allah wills a people's punishment, there can be no turning back from it, and they will find besides Him no protector. This opens up many avenues for us to think about this ayah and reflect upon it. And its reflection should be solely to look at yourselves, for me to look at myself, for you to look at yourselves, and evaluate the conditions you are upon. This doesn't mean you have to do everything. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أيها الناس إنكم لن تضيقوا أو لن تفعلوا كل ما أمرتم به ولكن سددوا وأبشروا The statement of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم when he said, O people, you are not able to, you will not do everything you were commanded to do, but instead, try to be upright. When you sin, come back to istiqamah, come back to steadfastness, leaving sin, doing good deeds, worshipping your Creator alone without partners, and give glad tidings. Our Prophet ﷺ, from Allah's inspiration and wisdom, told us, we will not be able to do everything. So the good condition we're upon doesn't mean we have to do all the good we're capable of. But we have to remain away from the evil and the sin, especially those that destroy one's deen. عن أبي ذر رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول الله عز وجل من جاء بالحسنة فله عشر أمثالها أو أزيد ومن جاء بالسيئة فجزاؤه سيئة مثلها أو أغفر ومن تقرب مني شبرا تقربت منه ذراعا ومن تقرب مني ذراعا تقربت منه باعا ومن آتاني يمشي آتيته هرولا ومن لقيني بقراب الأرض خطيئة لا يشرك بي شيئا لقيته بمثلها مغفرة رواه مسلم. In this hadith Qudsi, which is a hadith that the Prophet ﷺ told us of, but it includes a statement of Allah, not in the Quran. From Abu Dharr, he said that Allah's Messenger ﷺ said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, "He who comes to me with a good deed, I will reward it times 10 or more." This is when we think we're generous. There is no one close to the generosity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, rewarding and multiplying the reward, whereas we look at our generosity and think so highly of ourselves. When you do good, Allah will reward it by 10 times that amount or even more. But he who comes with the sin or the opposite, his reward will be only one like that, or I can forgive him for it. He who draws close to me a handstand, I will come close to him in arm's length. Again, Allah's generosity and his mercy, his love and his compassion. You go to Allah with just a handspan, he'll come to you in arm's length. You go to Allah in arm's length, towards his pleasure, towards his mercy, towards his obedience, he'll come to you a fathom's length. Whoever comes to Allah walking, you're slowly moving towards being obedient to Allah, Allah will come to you running. And whoever faces me with sins as great as the earth, if you were to come with sin upon sin, the size of this dunya, I will meet him with forgiveness nearly as much as his sin, as long as he does not worship along with me. When we hear this statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this hadith from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when we hear this and we see the world around us and the condition we're in, all we have to do is move towards Allah in obedience, towards him and his Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he will come towards us and meet us more than halfway. This hadith emphasizes the importance that the foundation of our deen has to be correct. Again, we must be firm and correct on our tawheed and aqeedah. First and foremost, for Allah, towards Allah, for him to better our condition. We can't expect Allah to better the condition we're in when our ummah, which should be pure from any shirk, is riddled with shirk. On our bodies, in our homes, in some of our masajid, we hear stories day in and day out, see them with our eyes, of shirk in our homes, trusting in other than Allah, going for refuge or rescue or help to other than Allah. This isn't in dunya matters, in worldly matters, in other things. When you're stressed or troubled, seeing people turn towards shirk. When we ponder or ask why we're in the state we're in, we must first look at our condition, and first and foremost, we must correct our tawheed and our aqeedah. عن شداد بن عوس رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الكيس من دان نفسه وعمل لما بعد الموت والعاجز من أتبع نفسه هواها وتمنى على الله رواه الترمذي وقال حديث حسن. عن شداد بن عوس رضي الله عنه, may Allah be pleased with him, he said that Allah's Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, the wise person is the one who calls himself to account. The wise one, the really smart one, doesn't have to have a PhD or doesn't have to have many letters after his or her name. The wise one is the one who looks at himself or herself in that mirror and says, what have you done today to obey Allah and his Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? What have you done today to disobey Allah and his Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? How have you helped Islam? How have you brought it to the people? Beginning first with yourself and your families and your community, and then to others. The wise one calls himself to account, refrains from haram because he knows Allah can see him, Allah can hear him, Allah has full knowledge of what is even in his mind, and he does noble deeds to benefit him after death. Everything you're doing is so that when you're gone, our focus is when we're gone, leaving something for those behind us. But when we're gone, the wise person has prepared a deposit, a bank, a retirement account that Allah will reward him or her with in Jannah by doing good deeds. But the foolish person is the one who subdues himself to his temptations and desires and seeks from Allah the fulfillment of his desires. This is the fool, the one who just wants to enjoy this life and wants Allah to let him enjoy this life and open doors for him to just enjoy this life, and he forgets about the Akhirah. So you are accountable, I am accountable, we are all accountable for our own deeds. The mere desire to do good without any action is not going to help us. The mere desire to do good without doing good is not going to help us. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال أن قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من حسن إسلام المرء تركه ما لا يعنيه. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in this hadith in the Sunan al-Tirmidhi, which is Hasan, it's acceptable, he said, the Prophet ﷺ said, it is from the excellence of a believer's Islam that he or she abandon of that which is of no benefit to him or her in this dunya or the next life. Imagine abandoning that. So when we engage in ghibah and namimah, in backbiting and slander, does this benefit you in this life? You may think it does, because you're trying to put someone down and raise yourself up. You may think it does, because then people may prop you up and think good of you. But in the hereafter you will fail. The perfection of a person's belief or the excellence of a believer's Islam is that they abandon that which is of no benefit to them in this dunya and the hereafter. Again, I remind myself and you, this life is not forever. Daily we're reminded, you can be young, you can be old. You can be healthy, you can be sick. Allah takes you when He wants to take you. And this is a command written before even your creation or your breath in this dunya. So be mindful of this. From an excellence of a believer's Islam is that they abandon that which has no benefit to him or her in this life or in the hereafter. So avoid that useless speech. If you act upon this good principle, you will save yourself from many evil and sins. Leave off that which doesn't concern you. Leave off that which won't benefit you in this life or the next. Look at the example of the fear of the companions. Their fear of standing before Allah, and not just with their sins, but Allah knowing what they used to think or what they used to feel. عن ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما قال لما نزلت هذه الآية وإن تبدوا ما في أنفسكم أو تخفوه يحاسبكم به الله قال دخل قلوبهم منها شيء لم يدخل قلوبهم من شيء فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قولوا سمعنا وأطعنا وسلمنا قال فألقى الله الإيمان في قلوبهم فأنزل الله تعالى لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا قال قد فعلت ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا قال قد فعلت واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا قال قد فعلت. حديث صحيح ورواه مسلم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم from Ibn Abbas, he said, from Ibn Abbas رضي الله عنهما, may Allah be pleased with them both, he said, when this verse was revealed, whether you disclose what is in your minds or you conceal it, Allah will call you to account according to it. Yani the actions, people can see them. You know you do them. Many times they're witnessed by others. But the companions, when they heard this ayah, وَإِن تُبْدُوا مَا فِي أَنفُسِكُمْ أَوْ تُخْفُوهُ يُحَاسِبْكُمْ بِهِ اللَّهِ, this one from Surah Al-Baqarah, when this verse was revealed, whether you disclose what is in your minds or your hearts or you conceal it, Allah will call you to account according to it. The companions became very stressed out, very worried, very troubled, and it appeared on their faces. It caused them anxiety. Because now, even the things that became a thought to them, they knew Allah and knew, and they were afraid that Allah would hold them accountable for it. Then Allah's Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he observed that. He said, قُلْ سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعَنَا وَسَلَّمْنَا. Say, we have heard and obeyed and submitted to the Lord. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw their distress. So what did he tell them to say? Say, we hear, we heard, we obeyed, And we submit to Allah. The narrator added, Allah instilled faith in their hearts and further revealed for their satisfaction another verse. Because they were worried about their being in good standing with Allah, Allah sent down verses to rest their hearts. So Allah sent down, Allah burdens not a soul beyond its capacity. It will get every good it earns and will suffer every ill it earns and commits. Our Lord call us not to account if we forget or we make a mistake. When they said that same verse, Allah said, I have done so. I have done so. They further said, our Lord, lay not on us a burden like you laid on those before us. Allah said, I have done so. Then the companions, radiallahu anhum wa radahum, they further said, and pardon us and have mercy on us. You are our protector. And Allah, He said, done. Their content, their worry, their anxiety, their concern was with Allah's pleasure of them. And then being in good standing with Allah. So Allah's Messenger, seeing this, told them, hear and obey and submit to Allah. And Allah revealed verses that He will forgive them. He will not bring upon them that what He brought upon those before them and the likes of it. So let us be aware that our condition is based on what we earn. And if we are on goodness, Allah will give us goodness. And if we are upon evil, then until we leave that evil, no good can come to us. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم إذ الله يغفر لكم ذنوبه. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونصلي ونسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Allah verily will not change the good condition the people are in as long as they don't change themselves, the good state that they are, the goodness that they are doing. So if they are in goodness, then Allah will not send evil upon them. And if they are in evil and sin, then their pitiful condition won't change until they leave off that sin. Evaluate this, because sometimes we're in states of sin, and we ask of Allah one time, and we expect for Him to grant it. And we're in states of sin, and doing evil. Allah cannot take you out of the sin or evil you're in, until you change what is in yourself. Correcting your tawheed and your aqidah. Establishing your prayers. Praying them as the Prophet ﷺ prayed them. Making your wudu properly, paying your zakat in man, fasting Ramadan, making your hajj, being good to your parents and your neighbors and the poor and the needy and the orphan, the neighbor you know, the neighbor you don't know, and of course, keeping your family ties. Minutes and hours, days and years, they go by. We're in pitiful states and conditions. They're appalling, they're horrible, they're embarrassing. But we look to others to improve our states. We look for haram ways to make us become advanced, and then we say we'll obey Allah. We look for those ways. But the one who can correct our condition and save us and protect us is none other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He doesn't need us, but we need Him. The system of getting goodness and good conditions is very easy. Allah said if we're in a state of goodness, it will remain with us until we leave doing good. And Allah said, هَلْ جَزَاءُ الْإِحْسَانِ إِلَّا الْإِحْسَانِ. Is there any reward for the good you're doing other than good? Would you do good upon good after belief? Do good upon good and Allah's going to reward you with evil or with harm? This doesn't mean that you won't be tested, because this is the way for the believer to be tested, to test his faith, to test his strength, to test his obedience to Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Don't get it confused. Oh, I'm doing good. I pat myself on the back. Why should harm befall me? Why should I lose my job? Why should I lose money? Why should I lose my loved one? It's not like that. And the two are totally separate. But when you're in a state of good condition and you're doing good, Allah will only reward you with good. ثُمَّ قَالَ اللَّهُ إِنْ أَحْسَنْتُمْ أَحْسَنْتُمْ لِأَنفُسِكُمْ وَإِنْ أَسَأْتُمْ فَلَهَا. And Allah said, if you do good, you do good for your own souls and your own selves. And if you do evil, then you do it against your own selves and your own souls. So how do we change our condition for the better? Can you change to something better without knowing it? Again, just like last week's mentioning of it. Al-ilm qabla al-qawl wal-amal. Knowledge precedes speech and action. You cannot act correctly to please Allah until you have knowledge. You cannot speak the truth until you have knowledge of what the truth is. It means going back to qala Allah wa qala Rasulullah. Going back to Allah said and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. So seek authentic knowledge as it precedes speech and action. Realize this first and foremost. Again, that foundation has to be what makes you a Muslim. It's not your zakat or your fasting or making hajj. What makes you a Muslim is your tawheed and your aqeedah being correct. This is what our salvation is, not just your good deeds. It's the mercy of Allah, which will only come on the true believers. And an amr bil ma'roof wa naha an al munkar. And to enjoin what is good and forbid what is wrong. We are the only ummah that was commanded to enjoin and speak out and act and even at the least bit hate with our heart, to enjoin what is good and forbid what is evil and wrong. We are the nation that was commanded to that with this statement, and we have abandoned it. We may do so for ourselves or someone directly in front of us from our loved ones, but we may see it amongst others and we ignore it. There's no love and concern. But in a nutshell, there's three or so stages to concede to. Realize your state that you're in, what you need to change. Many of us, and I advise myself first, are in self-denial. I fast, I pray, I give charity, I've made hajj. Ramadan comes, I'll fast again. I'll fast some extra fast. I'm good to my mom and dad, I'm good to my... We're in self-denial. Self-denial. We want to look at the good we do and we enlarge it. And the evil we do, we belittle it. When the companions were the other way, they looked at their sins like a mountain that they were standing by ready to crumble upon them. Evaluate yourself. Look at yourselves and your efforts. Your efforts will be a reminder to you of trying to do good, that you need to improve yourself and change yourself for the better. And address yourself before you address others. This is a big one. Address yourself. Correct yourself before you start correcting others. Remove the corruption and the evil you're in within yourselves before you go out to the masses and do so. When we do this, when we fear Allah sincerely, we will be motivated to better ourselves. We'll be more determined to change for the better. Then we can gain the istiqamah to obey Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam and be happy with that. Then we can be patient when we're tested by Allah, content with what Allah gives us of blessings and His decree, the good of it and the bad of it. But to do so, we need to strengthen our faith and leave off the haram. The humiliation on this ummah comes from our own hands, our own sins. The transactions of ghina, bayl ghina, the business transactions, the haram of them, the cheating, the stealing, the love of wealth, these are all things that are ruining, for example, the conditions of oneself, one's family, one's community, one's ummah. قال الله ولو أن أهل القرى آمنوا واتقوا لفتحنا عليهم بركات من السماء والأرض. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, and if the people believed and they had taqwa, again, iman is not just to say or just to believe in the heart. It is belief in the heart, the statement of your tongue and the actions of your limbs. If the people believed and they had taqwa, they were cautious to obey Allah and not stay away from disobedience, certainly we would have opened for them blessings from the heavens and the earth. وقال الله وما أصابكم من مصيبة فبما كسبت أيديكم. And whatever misfortune befalls you, it is because of what your hands have earned. إن الله لا يغير ما بقوم حتى يغير ما بأنفسهم. Allah will not change the good condition of a people until they leave the goodness that they're upon. So we ask Allah to make us firm on that goodness, Amen. To return this ummah to that state of elevation, Amen. That state of tawheed that elevates this ummah above all other nations. Amen.
آمين. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك أنت سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. سبحان ربك رب العزة يوم يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.